Thanks for joining me today. Today is, of course, the 120th anniversary of women's suffrage in New Zealand. So I started the day at 7 o'clock this morning with a breakfast that was really around celebrating that achievement. And I think sometimes we don't really kind of put enough credence into actually what New Zealanders did and achieved 120 years ago. And I was at a session last night that the former Prime Minister, Dame Jenny Shipley, was speaking, and also the Honourable Hekia Parata, who was a former Minister of Women's Affairs. And the discussion was around, you know, us being proud of the fact that New Zealand was the first country to give women the vote. And that was corrected very loudly and very strongly last night by those two speakers, because, as you will know if you know your history of New Zealand, there was nothing about giving women the vote. It was a very hard fought for battle, and that was of course led by Kate Sheppard, and there were some very pioneering men and women in her time that she mobilised the action and fought for the right of women to vote. And that's of course another area that we are world leaders. So it was really great to be part of the breakfast this morning and celebrating that achievement. But more importantly, kind of looking at, well, you know, now what? So 120 years after we got the vote, what is the next piece of work in terms of championing women? And it was really inspiring. There was a young speaker, Dr. Russell, who's a Iraqi dentist from Hamilton. And she was the young New Zealand Leader of the Year this year. And she was incredibly inspiring, showing very clearly how one person can have an enormous influence on not the life of just one person, but many, many, both here in New Zealand and in her home of birth, Iraq. So it was a very inspiring day, and one that was really thought-provoking in terms of the opportunity to reflect on what sort of cause and what sort of purpose and what sort of change do we as individuals and communities want to lead next. We've got Parliament sitting again next week. One of the things that's going to be fantastic over the weekend is I'm joining the Minister of Youth Development, Nikki Kaye, in Mangakino for announcement. And so can't say much more about it other than keep your ear to the ground for that announcement on Sunday afternoon. I'm really proud that the Minister's chosen the Taupo electorate to make that announcement for youth and youth development. I'm in Taupo for the day tomorrow. I've got a really fully booked constituent clinic, which is great to see. That's really the opportunity for people to come and bring any issues or concerns that they have, and can't always promise to get the outcome that you're wanting, but I will promise I will work my hardest to make sure that we're able to get things moving if there's an issue or problem that you need assistance with. Want to say finally a really, really big thank you to the organisations and individuals that supported the fashion fundraiser that we had for the Catwalk Trust last Thursday night with Flirts and Village Squire. And nerve-wracking as it was, I was one of the models. But it was really just a great example of how the Taupo community is really generous and backs a cause. So on behalf of the Catwalk Trust and the research that's now possible because of the funding that we managed to raise, I just want to say a big thank you. And I look forward to having another chat next week.